लाइफ टाइम अचीवमेंट ऑनरिंग डॉक्टर महाराजन आर यू देयर सर? यस आई कैन सी यू सर.
थैंक यू.
दिस लाइफ टाइम अचीवमेंट ऑनरिंग वॉज स्टार्टेड बाई वन ऑफ आवर पास्ट प्रेसिडेंट्स डॉक्टर अरुणाचलम. इज डॉक्टर अरुणाचलम हियर? आई थॉट ही लॉग्ड इन.
सर केम लॉग्ड इन सर.
और இந்த மீட்டிங்ல இருக்காரா அந்த மீட்டிங்ல இருக்காரா? ஓகே ஃபைன். சோ இன் ஐஎம்ஏ கோடம்பாக்கம் we have started honoring and we continue to honor those senior members of our own and those senior members who have hitherto not been recognized by society. That is how we started. Later on we progressed to honor other people who have contributed significantly to society. I am glad, sir, that this month you have been chosen for this award.
Thank you.
Have a honoring committee headed by Dr. Ellarasan and a few others who every month choose the person to be honored. I now have the pleasure to read out the plaque made out in your name, sir. Lifetime Achievement Award on this date, the 29th November 2020. The citation is awarded to Dr. S. Maharajan for outstanding contribution to the society in the field of medicine. He is a recipient of Government Gold Medal for School Education, alumnus of Madurai Medical College, was awarded MBBS in 1969 with Surgery Prize, joined Tamil Nadu Medical Services in 1970 and promptly awarded by the state and central government in 1972 for creating a world record by performing 1,330 vasectomies in a one-year period. He later completed MS in General Surgery in 1979 from the same medical college, securing university first. After completing 16 years in government service, he served in the Middle East and also started his own surgical hospital in Dindukal. He is now a senior surgical consultant in Best Hospital, Chennai, since several decades. Close to his heart, he is interested in coordinating with government and social organizations in rural health welfare schemes. He is a life member of ASI and IMA Kodambakkam branch. We, the president and members of Indian Medical Association Chennai Kodambakkam branch, feel proud to honor a doyen in the medical field. Sir, this plaque will reach you shortly by post,
along with
a shawl and a garland, normally which we will honor you with if you were in a physical regular meeting with us.
No.
May I request you to say a few words, sir?
Sure. Dear members, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are.
Okay. Well, IMA has given me 5 minutes. I think I will confine myself. Initially, few words about myself. I am blessed with wife, daughter's family, and son's family. Wife is Dr. Meenal Ochini, the main pulling force for my family. She is a workaholic lady, as a doctor, as a wife, as a mother, as a grandmother, etc., etc. My daughter is Dr. Sivasundari, who is the professor of OG in Savita Medical College, married to our gifted grandson, Dr. Gaudaman, who is a surgical oncologist and associate professor in Ramchandra Medical College. They both gifted us back with their lovable grandson. My son and daughter-in-law, they are in the software side. My son, having completed his higher studies at Canada, he is well settled there with our sweet granddaughter. Okay, this is for the family. Now, please permit me in a different way to raise 3 requests for this learned audience. I am repeating, it is only request. It's not suggestion, it's not advice or anything like that. It is only request. These requests have come out of my own mistakes, which I have made in the practice for the 50 years. Well, my first request is, never get perturbed when you face the problem. We have to face the problem. Nowadays, we are seeing a lot of negative things from doctors. Please avoid that. Be bold. We have got two powerful weapons. One is profession. Next, the main thing is prayer. Take my life as an example. After 16 years of government service, I ventured for a 60-bedded own hospital at Dindigul. Well, it was running fairly well for 7 years. For some reason or other, unfortunately, I was forced to dispose it. Imagine the situation. My entire yearning of 25 years was lost. I was at rock bottom, not knowing what to do next. There came the real support from my wife. Yes, she asked me two questions. Why you are upset? We have disposed the hospital, but we have not disposed our professional skill. You will say yes or no? I said yes. Second question she asked, we have done a lot of good things for others. God knows it. Why not we beg the God again and again to restore everything back? With these two questions, this is profession and prayer, we landed at Madras. In the next 25 years, with God's grace, we earned a few crores. Thanks to the great West Hospital, the superb Dr. Veerabhadran and his two sons, and the entire West Hospital team. God can restore everything. I am very comfortable. In fact, he has restored the wealth, the properties, the so-called family history, etc., etc., including the academic things which I lost. Because it was indirectly given by my daughter. Yes, she is a medal harvesting machine. In her medical curriculum, she got 10 gold medals, 14 meritorious awards, best outgoing medal, our own IMA gold medal for the university. Like that, it went on up to UK, where she got her gold medal in her MRCOG. The lesson is, God can restore everything back as long as prayer and profession is there. My second request is, please learn till the end. Normally we learn from seniors, I don't deny. My request is, please learn from the juniors. They are real stalwarts nowadays. Their field may be narrow, but they are stalwarts in their field. I am learning from juniors. My own example, my son-in-law, who is a surgical oncologist now, when he entered his MS 20 years back, I thought I am teaching him the basics of surgery. The real fact is, nowadays, he is teaching me back all the advancements in surgery, all the intricate techniques in surgery. To be short, what all I normally abandon is inoperable because of complications. Nowadays, he is operating and showing me still it is operable. This is the level. So let us not hesitate to learn from the juniors. My last request, very important request, please take care of your health and the health of your family. Normally, we are interested in others' health. It is acceptable. But please take care of your health and your family. Please don't follow me in this subject. 11 years back, when coronary angio was done, the cardiologist was shocked to see a 100% block in my LAD. Still the heart was beating. In fact, he was having a doubt. Doctor, are you still operating? Well, that was situation. Of course, stenting, everything was done. The heart started beating again and again till day to receive this award. Family is also important. Please take care of your family. Not like me. I looked at my wife as a working machine, not as a human being. I extracted the maximum from her as a doctor, mother, in all roles. Ultimate penalty I paid, I was crying in front of God when she was inside the operation theater for an emergency CAPG. Luckily, God saved her. For heaven's sake, I request, please don't commit such mistakes. You all should take care of your health. Have some periodical evaluation. Take care of your health. You all should march past my age with the active practice, with good health. With these three requests, let me conclude thanking the IMA, the body with which I am attached for nearly 5 decades. It is the silent body as well as an active body. Silent when in its absorbing all the criticisms. Very active. Active when it is executing programs like FSS, PPLSS, crisis management, etc., etc. I know they are very busy. Still, they find time to select old people like me and give them such prestigious awards. No words to thank them personally and on behalf of my family. I thank them. My prayers are for IMA, all the doctors, and all their lovable, affectionate, and sacrificing families. God bless everyone. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, Dr. Maharajan. I've had a similar experience like your second pearl of wisdom, employing juniors to assist in surgery. I'm a neurosurgeon by profession. And a few years ago, when one of my assistants left me, I was at loggerheads what to do because I didn't have senior people to assist me. So one of my professors said, why don't you take a junior person? Probably you will learn something. And it was an eye-opener. From then on, I have been taking only juniors to assist me, and I have been learning. It is really nice. And I was thinking, why did I waste the first 10 years of my life taking senior persons to assist me? Maybe I should have started, sooner.